Hello. So today we are going to have a review of binary and hexadecimal numbers in computing. And to start with, any student of computer studies knows that computers, they understand the language that we call binary. And when we talk of binary, we're actually talking about two numbers, which is a zero or a one. To start with, we know that when we have a single bit, which is actually a zero or a one, we have the basic storage for computer. But this bit is too small to store any character of the English alphabet or actually anything that can be typed from the keyboard. A bit cannot store anything, it is too small. In order to start storing data, we need to have what we call a byte, and it is equal to 8 bits. When you have 8 bits, that is the time you can start storing anything on a computer. For instance, if I have this weight, which is there, and you need to store this on a computer, the question is, how many bits are you going to need in order to store this weight? Obviously, each character there will have 8 bits times 3, because there are three characters, which simply means you will be in need of 24 bits. Unless they ask us how many bytes, we are going to need 3 bytes. If it's bits, that is 24 bits. So, based on this fact, that a computer starts storing data when it has a byte. So a byte is a very, very important concept about binary and hexadecimal numbers in computing. So what we are going to understand now is that we know that computers understand binary. And there are two types of bits. There is a zero or a one. Now, to store a data, we need a byte. So we are going to need 8 bits. And each of these can either be a two, I mean a zero or a one. So there are 2 bits there, zero or one. There are 2 bits there. And we are going to need these bits, 8 of them. So I have those 8 bits. Each digit there represents two numbers, either a zero or a one. Now, the first thing that you need to do before you start converting these numbers from our ways of counting zero to wherever we are going, which is a decimal, our binary number or hexadecimal number, we need to start by creating this benchmark, which will help us to convert the rest of the numbers. So the least bit is given to the power 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And we know that any number to the power of 0 is equal to 1. Any number to the power of 1 is equal to that number. Then 2 to the power 2 is equal to 4. 2 to the power 3, that is 8. 2 to the power 4, that is 16. 2 to the power 5, that is 35. 2 to the power 6, that is 32, not 35, sorry. Then this is 64. 2 to the power 7, it's 128. So we've got what we want. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 bits. And this is what we call a byte. And this is going to help us now to convert all the numbers that we need to convert from 0 up to any number. Even negative numbers can be converted. But as at senior secondary school, all we need to know to understand is convert the positive numbers in computer studies. So let's start with the decimal numbers. When we talk of decimal numbers, we are talking about the numbers we humans are accustomed to. The numbers that has become as a native way of counting for humans. And this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And these numbers for us humans, they are easy to understand. But the machine language, the binary numbers, they are different from the way we count. So we would want to understand why this 0 in decimal is equal to 0000 in binary. Why this 1 in decimal is equal to 0001 in binary, up to 15th, the 15th number. We are ending at the 15th number from 0, because from 0 to 15, we have 16 numbers. The reason why we have 16 numbers is because of hexadecimal. Hexadecimal goes up to 16 bits. Then our binary, we are going up to 8 bits. And this simply means the ways of our counting. So, for instance, we've been given this number 3 is written like this in the binary number. Can we prove this? We can prove this by using this template. And we are going to use the mathematical language, I would say, we want 3, which is a decimal, to be written into binary. So in order to do that, we need first to ask our question. From this benchmark that we have created, is there a number which is less or equal to 3 from this benchmark? And looking at that benchmark, we know that there is a number which is 2, and 2 is less or equal to 3. So where there is 2, we are going to put 1, and we get 2 and subtract it from our 3, and we remain with 1. And then we'll ask again, a number which is less or equal to 1. There is 1 there. And then we get the top 1, and we put it there, and we have a 0. So which simply means, the way we write our 3 in binary is simply these ones. Then the rest here are zeros. So this is how this 3 came about. We can look for at least 2 more examples. Let's say 7. We want to write 7 in binary number. We've seen the way 7 is represented there. But we need to prove this. We go back to our benchmark there. And we are going to ask ourselves that is there a number which is less or equal to 7 on this? So the number which is less or equal to 7 is 4. So it means under 4 we put a 1, then we get a 4 and subtract from 7. And we remain with the 3. Then we continue doing this until we get a 0. And say, a number less or equal to 3, that is 2. Under 2 we put a 1. We get a 2 and we subtract and we remain with a 1 left. So a number less or equal to 1, that is 1 itself. And when we get the 1 and subtract, we remain with a 0. And our 2 is done. So simply means we will take this 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, like that. And hence, this one deduced. We found out that 7 can be written like that in binary. There are a lot of these numbers. Let's try to pick any number outside this range. Let's say 21. Then we are going to convert now 21 to binary. We have 21. Then they say We have a number less or equal to 21 from our benchmark here. And we'd say the number which is less or equal to 21, it gives us a 16. We put 1 there. Then we get a 16 and we subtract. The difference there is 5. Then a number less or equal to 5 there, we have it's 4. Then we get a 4 and we subtract. And we remain with a 1. A number less or equal to 1, we put there, see, 1. And then we get the 1 there and we subtract and we have 0. So these gaps where there is nothing, we are going to put zeros. And then what we have now is actually 21 can be written like that in binary numbers. I hope that is clear. But for the sake of other people, we can actually look at one more example. Let me guess, maybe 69. They say, can you convert 69 to binary? So we are going to have 69 there. Let's try to convert it to binary. And then we say, is there a number less or equal to 69 from our table there? And we would say it is 64. Then we subtract. We get the 64 and subtract. And our difference is going to be 5. A number less or equal to 5, that is 4, we put 1 there. And we get a 4, we subtract, and we remain with a 1. A number less or equal to 1, that is 1 itself. When we get that 1 and subtract, finally we've got our 0. So where there are empty spaces, we fill them with the zeros. And the resultant binary number we get is equal to 69. That is 1, 2, 3, like that. So that is 69. So that is our first step in computer mathematics. We have successfully converted and we've learned that we can convert any decimal number to binary. And the secret is this. In the exam room, if you are able to remember this, you are safe. You may forget about how it came about, but please ensure you are able to arrive at this. The other method you can arrive at this, just to ensure that you have a 1. The next bit you say 1 times 2, 2. 2 times 2, 4. 4 times 2, 8. 8 times 2, 16. Times 2, 32. Times 2, 64. Times 2, 128. Until you have 8 of these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 bits. This is your passport to give correct answer to any binary problem that you are going to face. Then, what we've done is simply converting decimal to binary. But we can improve the other way around, binary to decimal. And that is one of the easiest. You've already been given a binary, like 3 there. The binary number is there. If you want to convert this one to that, all you need is to take this and put it there on the benchmark like that. Then, from there, you're only going to get the number where there is a 1. Forget where there is a 0, but the number on top where there is a 1, then you say 2 plus 1, and it will give you a 3. You've converted a binary to decimal. Then 7, it's the same story that we are going to follow. We are going to put it like that. That is the number we've got there. Then we get the numbers where there is a 1. Forget about the 0. We just get the numbers where there is a 1. That is 4 plus 2 plus 1. And that will give you a 7. You can do everything from binary to decimal by the use of this template we have created. Let's try to prove some of these numbers which have been given. Let's say 13. We've got 13 here. We have 13, they are saying, you see, 1101. See, the least bit there, then 1 1. Then they say, convert it to its equivalent decimal. You forget about this. What you're going to get is 1 plus 4 plus 8. Obviously, you know that 8 plus 4 is 12. 12 plus 1, it is 13. So that is how all these numbers came about. So we've done two things. What we've done, we have managed to convert binary to decimal and decimal back to binary by the use of this system. The last part we want to look at is how now to talk about hexadecimal numbers. So we'll look at the decimal, then binary, now hexadecimal. The first thing that you need to know about hexadecimal is that it has 16 bits, 0 to 15. Then secondly, what you would need to know about hexadecimal is that in binary, 0 to 9, it's the same we write in hexadecimal. So the same way we write 0 in binary is the same way we write 0 in hexadecimal. The same way we write 1 in binary is the same way we write 1 in hexadecimal, up to 9. The same way we write 9 in binary is the same way we write 9 in hexadecimal. Here, things are the same. The difference starts at 10. 10 in binary is written like that, but in hexadecimal it is A, 11 B, 12 C, 13 D, 14 E, 15 F. And then you'd achieve all the numbers in hexadecimal. But a simple story that we can look at in terms of converting numbers from hexadecimal back to decimal or binary, you may be given a number. Let me say A, B, C. This is an hexadecimal number. Then they say, can you convert this to binary and eventually convert it to its equivalent decimal number? So we need to start with A. Then A, simple story, we know that A is 10. A is 10. So we are taking first this to binary. We know A is written as that in binary. Another A is written as the same in binary. Then we go to B. We know B is written as 1011. And we say 1011. Then we go to C. C is written as C is 12. It's written as 1100. So that is 1100. That is its equivalent to binary. Just like that. Then when they say take it to decimal, it's easy. You group them in fours. There is this, and then there is this. Then the first thing you need to do is to get that group there, 1100, which is 1100, and this is, we forget about this, then 8 plus 4, that is 12. Then this one, which is 1011, which is 1011. Forget about this, we have 8, 10, 11. So that is 11, which is actually a B there. That is 11, because 11 is written like that And that's the same one we are getting there. Then A, we know that A is 10, but we need to prove this so that we erase the doubt. So we know that this is 0, this is 0. So 8 plus 2, that is 10. Another A, it is 10. Then you add these numbers and you get the equivalent by decimal numbers. So from there, this is 20, 32, 32, 43. So the total is going to be 40, 43 in decimal. As simple as that. We can look for at one more example possibly. Let's look at one more example and we can call it a day. Then we can say, what if you've been given 2DF1? This is the hexadecimal. And then they say convert it first to binary. 2, we know how to write a 2 in binary. And for the sake of reinforcing learning, we can just say a number which is less or equal to 2 there, it is 2, we put a 1. Then we get a 2 and we subtract, it's going to give us a 0. So we know that there is going to be zeros. And this is the same way we write a 2. From where we have come from, we know that a 2 is written like that. So there we're going to say 0, 0, 1, 0. Then you go to D. What is D? You know that D is 13. And it's written like that. Or else, if you don't want to do that, you know that D is 13, we can look for a number which is less or equal to 13 from our benchmark. And then we'd say the number which is less or equal to 13 is 8. Then we are going to subtract. So 13 minus 5, 8 is equal to 5. And the number less or equal to 5 is 4. Again, we get a 4 and subtract, we remain with a 1. Less or equal to 1, it's 1. And then we're going to remain with 0. Then there we're going to put a 0. So this is how the 13 came about. And then we know that this one is 1, 1, 0, 1. Then we've got the F. And the F, we know it is 15, the last number, which has 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. And we can prove this for the sake of reinforcing our understanding. We are going to say 15. A number less or equal to 15, it's 8. Then we are going to subtract. And the difference there, I guess it is 7. Then the number less or equal to 7, it's 4. Then we subtract, we remain with 3. Less or equal to 3, it is 2. Then we subtract 2 and we remain with 1. Less or equal to 1, it's 1. And when we subtract, we get a 0. So this is how this number came about. So there is F, we say 1, 2, 3, 4. Then 1, we know how to write 1 in binary. So we say 0, 0, 0, 1. So you have converted the hexadecimal to binary. And then the next thing that you need to do is we group them in fours because they are 16. Then we know this is 1, this is 15, then this is, what is this number? We found it was 11, and this is 2. Then you add them to get the equivalent hexadecimal. And your result is going to be the final answer there. And sometimes the examiners don't want to confuse the students. Why they say that this binary number, can you convert it to hexadecimal? So when you are converting this to hexadecimal, always remember to group them in fours. This is the group, this is the group, this is the group, and that is the group. So you look at this group. What number is this?
If you don't know this number, we take it back to the benchmark there, and it will give you that this number actually is a 1. Then this is a 1. And we know that a 1 is written just as the same, but we eliminate the zeros when we are writing it in hexadecimal. We are just going to put it as a 1. Then this number is 15, and 15 is F, because 15 is F. The next number there, this one looks like 11, that is 11, and 11 is B. This number there, it looks like a 2, because that's the way we write a 2, then we are going to put it like that. So 2BF1 is the equivalent to this binary number. By that, you would have completed your tasks. So what you need to remember is that there are hexadecimal numbers and there are binary numbers. The last question I saw in the Examination Council of Zambia exam paper, the past paper, they were asking of the advantages of using binary over hexadecimal. We know that the language of a computer is binary. So the best answer you can give in such a scenario is that binary is already in machine language. The computer will understand it, because computer cannot understand hexadecimal. It understands the binary. So binary is machine language. And the main advantage is that it's the native language of the machine, and it will be understood by the machine so fast. But the main advantage of using hexadecimal is that, like you can see these two numbers, hexadecimal are shorter than binary, which means humans work well with hexadecimal than binary. This number is too long. There are 16 bits. But there we won't have 4 characters, which simply means it is shorter for us to work with. And then it's easier to know the number in hexadecimal than in binary, because we know B is 12. But this is confusion. First, you need to divide them in groups of 4s for you to understand those. So you need to know that in hexadecimal, 1, they are shorter, and 2, they are easier to remember by humans than binary numbers. Like that, you would have grasped all the concepts needed to understand the computer mathematics. So we are going to end here today. But next time, in the next video, what we are going to do is we're actually going to look at the past paper questions and see if we can answer them. By that time, we would have worked entirely with the computer mathematics. So, bye for now and see you next time.